Hi, Derek Briggs, Product Manager for Tsugami REM Sales. And today I'm going to show you how to navigate folders in a FANUC 32i or 31i B control. So to navigate through the folders in a FANUC control, they're all basically the same, the way the folders are labeled from the factory. No matter what user you're using, whether it's Tsugami or anybody else for that matter, most machine tool builders leave it the same. So what we're going to do is we're going to press in edit mode. We're going to go to the folder. And it's going to bring us to CNC memory is typically going to be where we're at. Now this is critical up here, this foreground folder and background folder, okay? This page also shows you some other important information, which is how much memory is being used in the machine and how much you have free. Now typically, you can also check what your storage capacity is on your machine by looking in this screen as well. Same thing with used files and free files. How many programs can you put in the machine, how many are in it, and how many are free? So this is very critical. If you get out of the proper folder, sometimes you won't be able to find your program. Sometimes you won't be able to call up the proper program. So sometimes it's real easy to do. Some people will hit this input button while return to upper folder is highlighted. And they're gonna press that, and now all of a sudden, you're here. And then you accidentally press it again, and now you're here. So now you've moved up two folders, and you're not sure exactly how to get back. And this has happened to a lot of customers. What'll happen is they'll load a program from a USB stick into their control, and it'll actually load into this folder. Well, the machine doesn't know to look. It's gonna try to look in the foreground folder. That's why I said this is critical here. It's looking in CNC memory user path one. So if you ever find yourself, you're all the way into CNC memory, that's the current folder you're in. You just want to go down to CNC memory, user, and path one. So let's go to user and press input. It opens the folder. And let's go to path one, and we're going to open that folder. That's where all your programs should be stored if your foreground folder says that path. Now I'm working on a three-path machine today. So NC2, it's going to be CNC memory, user, path two. Same thing happens if I press input and input. Now I'm back in system, which is nothing in there. I have MTB1, nothing in there. The only thing I should have is user, and I'm gonna go ahead and find my appropriate path. Having said that, I can look at what programs are also stored in maybe path one or path three from path two. I'm currently right now in path two. So I can go up to return to upper folder, and I can see what is stored in my library in path one. So my current folder is user path one. But my foreground folder is CNC memory user path two. If I was to run a program right now from path two, this is where it would search for the program. I'm just using this as a navigation tool down here at this point. So 0001 is in my path one folder. And this little asterisk, that means that's the current program that is called up in path one. So if I was to go back to NC1 and I press program, one is the program that's called up in NC1. That's what that little asterisk means, okay? I go back to NC2 and I return, and I'm gonna go back to path two, input. Now I get the at symbol here, and that's gonna tell me that that's the program that I'm on in path two. Because it's not an asterisk, I know I'm in the proper folder. I also can tell by CNC memory, user path two matches my foreground folder. If your foreground folder gets changed for some reason, if you look up and you're in path two on your control, and you look up and all of a sudden, this doesn't say path two. It actually, in foreground folder, says path three. So let's go ahead and make that happen. Let's go to path three, and I can say foreground change. Now you see CNC memory user path three. So now I'm actually looking at path three up here. So if I tried to call a program, it would look into path three. So if you load your path two program in path two folder, but this is not set correctly, you are gonna actually look in path three folder to find your path two program. And it'll probably say program not found. Always make sure that your foreground folder matches the path that you're in. So we're gonna go to return to upper folder. We're gonna arrow down to path two, and I'm gonna say foreground change. It's gonna change my foreground folder to path two. Everything's squared away. We're good to go. Path one is path one, path two is path two, and path three is path three. That's how you navigate the folder system on a FANUC control.